Hi, everybody.
Hey, everybody.
All right.
Just clarifying a few things, kind of running around a little bit. It's okay.
And that's how it is, day three.
Yes, it is.
So
it is day three, near the end of day three.
That's right. But I am pleased to be with you.
Yes, back again.
And we are certainly pleased to be bringing you this incredible game, game number 46 here on Sunday, day three, ECDX 2019. And it will feature number 9, Philly Roller Derby, your hosts for ECDX.
Yes.
Going up against number 10, Rainy City Roller Derby All-Stars from Manchester, UK.
Yes.
So who do you want to read?
I'll read Rainy City since I just finished talking. That's why I was running back and forth across the bridge here. So I'll introduce Rainy City All-Stars. That's number 11, Faye Roberts. Number 16, 18, Fred Finta. 24, Rolo Tomasi. 29, Penny Block. 311, Ella Diablo. 316, Lily Gaskell. 417, Stopless. 419, Ruthless Philly. Number 45, Avron. Number 5, Lauren Swaffield. Number 6, Rascal. 6955, Menace. Number 7, Mia. 77, Liz Yeatman. Yeatman, I believe that's the way you should pronounce that. 81, Fairy Quake. Coach today by Michael Watson, who's wearing the A. Una Bomber, Sam Swaffield, and Tom Pritchard.
All right, and for your Philly Roller Derby Liberty Bells, as we said, ranked from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, ranked number 9 in the Wftda, skating in black. Number 00, Meryl Stripper. 138, Buenos Diaz. 15, Persephone. 152, Corey Herman. 1818, and Frankenstein. Number 21, Tramagotchi, your captain. Number 34, Jail Bars. Number 416, Crank Dat. Number 45, Built to Spill. Number 501, Reptar. Number 66, Little Loca. Number 85, the legendary Teflon Donna. Number 902, Rousey. Number 957, Ginger Vitus. And number 99, Russian Bayou. And we are underway here in jam number 1. And it is going to be Mia jamming for Rainy City, who is out of the pack first and will be lead jammer.
I'm so that's 501. That's what is on the scoreboard. I'm going to trust that.
Yeah.
Because we had so much going on here. But we're ready.
We're ready. So that was Reptar jamming for Philly. Able to get out of the pack, but not able to score. Rainy City will pick up 4 points, a 4-0 score, and that's how our game begins.
I will say, shout out to Philly for putting on a really amazing event.
It has been amazing. The Derby has been extremely high level.
Very high level.
I don't know if everybody got to see that. Oh, we worked that Misfits,
yeah.
St. Louis Gatekeepers game yesterday.
Gatekeepers game, yes.
Certainly one of the biggest upsets of the weekend. All right, underway in jam number 2, Fairy Quake and Corny Herman jamming. And Fairy Quake is out front first, 2 in a row for Rainy City.
Nice little spin move there, but Philly's able to reform in front.
Yeah, they closed the spin.
Yeah.
Corny Herman out of the pack now, about a quarter track behind the pack. And Fairy Quake will call the jam. Let's see if some points go up. They do, in fact. 3 points go up for Rainy City, a total of 7 now. Philly yet to get on the board.
So just talking with Rainy City right before I came up on the bridge, and this is the first time that they've been to Pennsylvania, so they're pretty excited.
Wow.
Yeah. And they've played lots of teams from all over the world here in Feasterville. Feasterville Trouvose, I believe, is the correct.
It's hyphenated.
It's hyphenated place, yes. Yeah.
All right, so we're underway in jam number 3, and jamming for Philly is Rousey, but
wow.
It is Lauren Swaffield with the star for Rainy City, and that is 3 in a row for the team from Manchester.
Yes.
Swaffield back in the pack now, facing off against 3 Philly blockers.
Yeah, I mean, it looks like that's Lily Gaskell trying to run a little interference there, but Philly is not having it.
All right.
Oh, no. Yeah.
So a forearm is the penalty against Rousey, and that will be a power opportunity for Lauren Swaffield, who's out of the pack now, having completed her first scoring pass.
That took a lot to get out of that Philly defense to pull out of the pack.
Yeah, that was a full minute to levy that scoring pass. Lauren Swaffield back in the pack now, which has picked up its pace a little bit as they round turn 2.
Ooh.
Swaffield knocked to the inside. Good block there by number 66, Little Loca. And so Lauren Swaffield will call the jam, having secured a total of 7 points on the jam. That pushes them to 14 and Philly still with 0 points.
And that call off there also secures a power start for Rainy City. Jammer not even standing as of yet, so yikes. Rousey is more than 10 seconds of a power start here.
All right, that is number 1618, I believe, with the star, Fred Finta. And Fred Finta through the pack. Oh, but there is a penalty being called. It is a forearm penalty against Fred Finta.
So this is interesting. So I just mentioned that number 902, Rousey, is in the box, but picked up two penalties. One was for the misconduct in addition to the forearm. So I'm not sure if she didn't leave the track fast enough or what that was. So this is interesting. Sat for that 30 seconds, but the first 30 seconds cleared that. But this other penalty on Rainy City's jammer now let her out of the box. I mean, when she was potentially not even standing yet.
Yeah. So Fred Finta actually backing out onto the track now, rejoining the pack in turn three. Rousey having been declared lead at the front of the engagement zone on a scoring pass. Yeah. Wow.
I know.
Oh, nice move by Rousey. No. Didn't go out, so able to stand up immediately and face off against just the one Rainy City blocker and complete a scoring pass there. And, of course, Rousey in control of the jam now on a second scoring pass. Oh, getting knocked to the inside. Good hit block by number 7-7, Lizzie Aitman. Rousey re-engaging, crossing the jammer line. Bit of a barn door to the right there, and back at the front of the pack. But
that pack slowly inching up that straightaway.
All right. Well, Fred Finta out of the pack and on a scoring pass, but not able to score. Jam called by Rousey. Philly on the board finally. 7 points for them. 0 for Rainy City. A 14-7 game. Rainy in front. All right, I see number 7, Mia, with the star for Rainy City on the Frogmouth Jammer line.
501, I believe that's Reptar. Again, I'm very impressed with I'm very impressed with the defense here. It's those jammers are so far not a really deep jammer rotation, so. I can't imagine how hard it is to get through those defensive walls.
There you go. Well, Mia had been declared lead and is still lead. Reptar is out of the pack, having completed her initial pass.
So Mia making the call off there before Reptar is able to get around.
And it looks like 2 points will go up, 3 points for Rainy City. They'll increase their total to 17. And Philly with 0 points on that jam, they are at 7. So a quickly moving game so far. We are just 7 minutes in and already going into jam number 6. And I see number 81.
As soon as you say that, we get a timeout.
Yeah, they must have overheard me. They're like, hang on a minute. Let's slow this down. I got to give those announcers a chance to talk about the Derby Apex. The Derby Apex, of course, your independent source for women's flat track derby news, rankings, and more. Visit TheDerbyApex.com and follow them on Twitter at the Derby Apex. And of course, Rippy, this broadcast, as it has been all weekend long, brought to you by the Derby Apex.
Really appreciate that. There are camera people here, so we only have one camera on each track, but you know, camera people operating the camera, keeping it moving so that the audience, the viewing audience, can see what's happening on the track. Really appreciate all of the Apex's support so that we could get this to you. You actually have the viewing audience actually has a really sweet view. We are looking through a chain link fence.
Yeah, we're sort of a half a mile from the venue with a bank of trees in front of us. But no, from high above track three on the Eagle's Nest. But we do, our table is situated right behind a chain link fence, which is in front of a vinyl anti-hockey puck fence.
Yeah. So.
And so we have sort of a, so we're kind of bobbing the whole game, just kind of going back and forth, trying to see through the gate.
Sometimes it's a little difficult to see how many fingers a jam ref is holding up, for example.
That's right.
And sometimes the numbers look a little different because this is nice white font on the Philly jersey, so they don't get confused with the fence.
Much appreciated. Also with the Gotham All-Stars, the white numbers on black jerseys. Thank you so much.
And let's give a shout out to all Sans Serif fonts. Let's ahead and do that.
Yeah.
Shout out to Sans Serif so that we can actually read your jersey.
That's right. That's right. If the Wftda is going to legislate anything, it should be that.
I mean, you can write your name in all kinds of cursive.
Sure,
you know,
whatever
your team
you want.
Name, whatever on
That's
the front,
right.
But the numbers should be sans serif.
Yeah,
thank you.
Crayon. We don't mind.
Yeah.
But so we are in an official review right now.
Yes, that morphed.
Official review having been called by Philly. Oh. And I just signaled down to Jim. He doesn't have to. I hope he doesn't think he has to come up here. I just want.
No,
to
I am going to come down there. Is what I'm going to do.
Okay. Oh, okay. Well, Rippy's going to go down and find out what the official review is all about. But it does appear to be over as the coaches are returning to their various benches and the officials are assuming their pre-jam start positions. And we will be underway once again in jam number 6 here. On the line for Rainy City, that's number 81, Fairy Quake. And that is number 152, Corny Herman, with the star for the Liberty Bells. All right, that whistle starts the jam. And Corny Herman out front, taking an outside lane and seizing the lead jammer position for Philly. And we are without a producer at this game, but I think that is one of the very few, if not the only, lead jammer position awarded to Philly thus far in the game. So, Rippy's got a smile on her face. It must be a good one. Corny Herman through the pack, now having completed a scoring pass. We're all ready.
So we don't have a producer. So
yeah,
we are doing double team up here. I will tell you about this official review as soon as this jam is over.
There you go. So we have had a star pass, I believe, for Rainy City. And almost immediately after that, Fairy Quake went to the box as a blocker. So it is Bonchet with the star. Oh, and Bonchet now being assessed to cutting the track penalty. So with a minute left on the jam clock, this will be a power opportunity for Philly. And they are taking full advantage now, having taken the lead with three full 4-point passes, 12 points on the jam, 19-7, your in-jam score update.
Nice job up here with the two wall.
Yeah, the pace slowing to a stop there,
yeah.
And then an out-of-play penalty being assessed to number 77, Liz Yateman. And that will free up Corny Herman for another pass.
Skip and a hop over that straight away.
Well, that's a 5-pass jam for the Liberty Bells. A total of 20 points on the jam. A 20-0 jam in favor of Philly Roller Derby. And they will go up now by 10, 27-17.
Wow, just like that. So basically that official review, Philly was asking for a low block to be called on a Rainy City jammer. The no call will stand, and they lost their review, as you can see from here.
There it is. The dot is gone.
The dot has disappeared.
All right. Well, we are underway now in jam number 7. Persephone taking the star for the first time in this game, going up against Lauren Swaffield.
Wow. Swaffield getting locked down in that Philly defense.
Yeah, look at that. Number 99, Russian Bayou, taking part in the grind. Number 34, Jail Bars.
The Persephone driven out of bounds, but is able to come right back in. But the Rainy City wall forms in front. She's able to spin around, work her way through that.
Wow, that is a slow moving engagement.
Yes.
Just barely into turn one now.
It's a mass of bodies.
Swaffield, helmet cover in hand.
Yeah, Swaffield not completed the initial yet, so yeah. Just really locked down. And now Swaffield has moved from the jammer line to the top apex, and that is all.
Yep.
So, yeah, it's got to be up there. Oh, nice swing hit there by Faye Roberts, but didn't quite stop Persephone,
nope.
But did get a little in her way.
Slow down there, but one scoring pass complete. And with 40 seconds left on the jam clock, Persephone is still lead jammer. And we'll take the opportunity to call the jam. And I believe there was a star pass there.
Yeah.
For Rainy City there at the end of the jam. And so the net result is a 7-0 jam in favor of Philly. They are up 34-19 now with 19 minutes remaining here in the first half.
This gives me an opportunity to tell you about Frogmouth. And Frogmouth is a proud sponsor of our jammer line. Derby uniforms and a practice wear, size inclusive, gender neutral, skater made, woman owned, and derby owned. That's Frogmouth.
All right, underway in jam number 8, Buenos Diaz jamming for the first time in this game up against Fred Finta.
Wow.
That is going to be a low block.
Yes.
It was effective in stopping Buenos Diaz, but Buenos Diaz able to pop up and resume her path to
and
lead jammer.
Finta also headed to the penalty box here.
That's right. So this is a power opportunity for Buenos Diaz. And Buenos Diaz will capitalize 4 points already on the jam.
So legal position was the call for Fred Finta.
Aha. Mm-hmm.
Oh, and after a little battle there with, again, 88, we've already mentioned Banshee. You pronounced it. You didn't pronounce it Banshee, did you?
Did I? What did I say?
I don't know what you said, but I looked up and I went, oh, maybe it's pronounced it differently. It's 88.
88. Oh, it's... I said Banshee.
Banshee.
Yes, waiter. I'll have
the Banshee.
Yeah.
I'll have the Banshee.
My goodness. Well, in my defense.
I like it.
If there can be any defense of that.
I mean.
It is written in Sharpie.
It is
on
written
my roster.
In Sharpie.
Yeah.
And it's also crossed out once. And
it
now
is, it as is. Though they were not in the game.
And
yeah.
Now they are. So. I like Banshee.
That's
I'm going to tell her
okay,
that
we're going to start. Yeah, Banshee.
So,
yeah, that's that is the Esperanto for Banshee. All right. Well, regardless, a timeout had been taken by Rainy City, and now that timeout is almost complete. And a score update for you: 38-19 in favor of Philly. 17 minutes and 50 seconds on the game clock here in the first half. And now we have morphed into a official timeout.
Timeout, yeah.
See one of the officials coming over to the scorer's table. That gives us time to talk about Rainy City already this weekend. They handled Atlanta 165-110, and then they were able to beat Santa Cruz 133-94. So they're 2-0 on the weekend.
Yes,
yeah.
They're doing quite well.
They are.
They seemed very excited to be here and to just be able to play. But they've pulled out some wins as well. So.
Yeah. And I am getting this information, as I'm sure you are all aware, from stats.wftda.com, which is, wow, it is impressive.
Yeah,
it's
very comprehensive.
Yeah, it's like ice cream the way it used to be back in the day, and it can give you continuously updated rankings in the WFTDA, so be sure and check that out. We're all so proud of it.
I mean, it is really neat because we had so many tournaments happening this week, or events. I mean, even just not even big tournament, big events happening this weekend. And so it's nice to be able to look straight at the computer and be like, okay,
that's right.
They moved.
It couldn't have gone online at a more opportune time, as June signaling, of course, the end of the rankings calendar ahead of playoffs. And meanwhile, we're back to the action on the track. Jam number 9 underway. Raptor versus Mia. Reptar having been recycled now between the lines. Amia, ooh, getting knocked to the inside and having to recycle back to the pivot line.
That is Gaskell, Lily Gaskell, having a seat in the penalty box.
All right, the jam ref checking to make sure, and then able to signal Reptar lead jammer. Reptar back in the pack now in turn one. Yeah, Faye Roberts once again, great recycling as part of the Rainy City defense now. So good containment from Rainy City, and they started out pants afire and have since dropped back offensively a little bit, but they're in this game.
So that's Faye Roberts looked at the referee and thought the whistle was for her.
Yeah.
It was not. So Mia out of the pack now on the initial. Looked for a star stash. And I think that was, is that Little Loca?
Yeah.
In the penalty box?
Yeah, the second of two blockers in
the penalty
box right now. So Rainy City will start with a pack advantage. They will send number 81, Fairyquake, to the line. And that is the Frogmouth start line. To be opposed by number 902, Rousey. As we are about to get underway in gem number 10. Speaking of games already this weekend, Philly playing London. And that was yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And they were victorious over London, 175 to 128. Nice. Fairyquake able to find room on the outside and sidestep through for lead jammer for Rainy City.
Rousey being recycled back past the Frogmouth jammer line, but another scoring pass there, I'm sorry, for Fairyquake. I didn't mean another scoring pass, just another pass, which was a scoring pass.
Good side-to-side action from Fairyquake.
Oh, Rousey just having a time back here against Rainy City's tripod. No space, and as soon as I say that, of course. See, we have to use your announcer curse for good.
That's
right?
True. If it's going to be used, it should be for good.
If it's going to be a curse, I'm going to say things so that they get out of the pack.
Very effective. All right, well, that jam will come to an end. And Rainy City there able to put up a zero against Philly. That's got to be the first scoreless jam for Philly in a handful here.
Yeah.
So 10 points go up on the jam for Rainy City. That puts them at 29. Philly's still in the lead, though, at 46.
Oh,
all right,
big
here
hits there.
Yeah,
wow.
Got to say, we are going into jam number 11 here in Persephone off the line, but picking up a penalty. And
cut track, it looked like, maybe.
Is that a cutting?
Yeah, cut track. Mm-hmm.
So that's going to create an opportunity for Lauren Swaffield. Lauren Swaffield will burst through and pick up lead jammer status for Rainy City.
Lauren Swaffield out that very first time for the big, huge jam, and then Philly kind of isolated her there for a minute, and now she's finding a little wind under her feet.
Yep, one scoring pass complete, able to find room on the inside and notch 4 points. Back into the pack now on a second scoring pass as Persephone exits the penalty box. And Persephone will be on her initial pass.
Almost had that tripod broken, but not quite, by Lily Gaskell. Trying to disrupt things, and now looks like Penny Block, right?
Yeah, Penny Block coming up trying to free some room and getting assessed a penalty for that.
Maybe. Yeah.
So Swaffield now getting tangled up considerably. Oh, managing to stay in bounds.
Wow.
Despite a strong block there by number 21, Tramagotchi.
Lily Gaskell and Faye Roberts, that team of blockers out there doing a great job of breaking up, doing what they can, breaking up the tripod and opening up a space for their jammer. Just a 1-2 punch.
So Philly there able to secure 2 points, but 8 points will go up for Rainy City, and your score 48 to 37 now. Rainy City's closed the gap to 11 points. As we get ready to go into jam number 12, got about 12 minutes left here in this first half. And I see number 311, Ella Diablo, with the star for Rainy. And that is number 45, Built to Spill. Built to Spill is the pivot. Sorry. So that's number 15, Persephone, jamming for Philly.
152. Corny Herman. There we go.
Corny Herman, thank goodness you're here.
Well, you know,
there's
fence.
Only so many players on the roster that I could have continued to get that incorrect. But, all right, so...
Ella Diablo out of the pack now, but it's Herman that has lead and decides to call it.
Well, opt to call lead and able to increase the Philly lead by two more points. So 50-37 is our score. There it is. We, as we mentioned, we're in day three. Just a little bit more derby, but it's all going to be good. Actually, over on track two right now, you know, just if you're interested, Gotham and Atlanta. And then we have two more great WFTDA games coming up. I'll tell you about that in a minute here. We're underway in jam number 13 with Mia versus Buenos Dias.
The pack made it. I'm kind of shocked the pack made it all the way around here to turn three before we got hung up. Usually they're hung up at one or two.
Turn one. Mia angling. Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. Able to stay in bounds and angle around Russian Bayou. And Russian Bayou is going to be assessed a high block for her action on that engagement.
One-on-one defense is really it's really difficult. And so when I see a player that can do it really, really well, it's unfortunate that they pick up a penalty for it. But
the name Steph Maney comes to mind when I think about quality one-on-one defenders.
Yes. Oh, yes. Little help there. Was that jail bars or? I'm sorry, I cannot see the number, but I want to give credit to that wonderful person's hit.
Yeah, no, I would say it is jail bars. Jail bars has been locking down, if you'll pardon the prison analogy, the front of the defensive efforts.
It's 316, right? Yeah, 316, Lily Gaskell. I've said that name before. I should know her by now.
Oh, I thought you were talking about Philly.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, jail bars is Philly, so there you go.
There you go. All right, well, Mia able to call the jam and do it in time enough to prevent Philly from scoring and able to put up 12 points of her own, and that brings Rainy City to within 1 point as we get ready to go into jam number 14. 50-49 is your score. So exciting efforts by Rainy City here in the four jams to bring themselves back.
Yeah, Philly was trying to put a lot of space there, and Rainy City put a stop to that.
All right, so Fairy Quake with the star for Rainy. And according to the screen, Corny Herman jamming for Philly again.
Well, we recycle there on Fairy Quake. Oh, big recycle there on Fairy Quake by Meryl Stripper.
But it is Corny Herman able to escape the front of the pack first. Secure the lead jammer position for Philly. Back into the pack on a scoring pass now as Fairy Quake has removed the helmet cover. Is going to drop a matrix move on the outside line, but we'll have to recycle.
Yeah.
That's been being used this weekend, so I felt free to use it.
I've seen several players use the old...
The matrix move, The Neo, if you will. All right, so great defense from the Liberty Bells on this jam, able to force Fairy Quake to repeatedly recycle.
And one blocker to beat there for Herman.
And so that is the first scoring pass for Corny Herman, and we've had a star pass for Rainy City. Number 88, Bonchet. Now with the star for Rainy. The things that you hope never stick. I don't know. That is funny, though.
That's it's funny, and it's, you know, it's like calling Target Target.
That's right.
Like,
that's right.
It's just a cute.
Just
way
elevated
to say
it
the
there.
Name.
So yes, we've yes. Shout out to the Derby Apex. Don't make me regret that. All right, here we go. Jam number 15. And we are underway. It's number 501 Reptar going up against number 5 Lauren Swaffield. And Reptar being wow. forced to the midpoint between the lines as
Boom.
Swaffield is up front.
Faye Roberts again. That hip comes out and the body goes flying.
Yep.
You just, it's so solid, such a solid hit.
And Penny Block, of course. Nice
yeah.
combination defense from
Look
Penny
at that.
Block.
Yep.
And Faye Roberts right there. And again.
And I like how Rainy City, right there, you can see a really nice view of it, is that they bump the jammer out, they recycle the jammer, but it's not half a track
yeah.
recycle, because that just gives them way too much space. So they're able to, the blockers are able to get back in, really reform really quickly, and you know, stop the jammer.
But time does go by, and holes are created, and Reptar able to streak through one of those and secure the lead jammer position for Philly now, and on a scoring pass.
Reptar Ooh. Actually slipping through on the outside. Puts points on the board. Now Swaffield is out of the pack. Oh.
Yeah, Reptar getting knocked to the outside, able to grab one more point on that pass for a total of 5 on the jam. And so a 61-49 score. Philly in front now with 5 minutes and 40 seconds left in the first half. And Rainy City having sent Lily Gaskell to the penalty box for the majority of that jam, and it shows. You know, when Lily Gaskell is out there, the magic can happen.
Really,
so.
Yeah.
All right, here we are underway. Number 311, Ella Diablo, will jam for Rainy. And is that number 902, Rousey, with the star for Philly. And Rousey able to
nice.
Squeak through the pack really quick and pick up lead jammer for Philly. And we've had a star pass for Rainy City. That is number 88, Blanchet. Pivot, now jammer. But Rousey will get into the pack in an attempt to score. Looking for points there. I don't see anything going up.
There
they
yeah,
are.
There we
so,
go. There we go.
So 3 points for Philly there. That puts them at 65-49 for Rainey. 4 minutes and change remaining here in the first half.
Yeah, you were talking about the schedule earlier, and I think your best bet if you're a viewer here is just to have multiple computers
yes.
and just you know, set up, and you can watch all of these games.
All the Derby. All right, underway in jam number 17, Mia versus Buenos Diaz. Oh, Mia recovering from a
wow.
3 block from the Philly defense.
Oh, little spin move.
Getting knocked to the outside, and it looks like she's going to stay outside.
Picks up something.
Yeah.
We will look and see what that is. That's a high block?
So that high block
what, yeah.
for Mia will create a power opportunity for Buenos Diaz.
Buenos Diaz into that Rainy City defense. You'll see Rascal hanging back as the bridge, as Philly tries to hang back to stretch out the pack for their jammer.
Look at that. That's a two blocker bridge right there.
Yep.
That is awesome.
Yep.
But ultimately, Buenos Diaz will have to be released.
But you know what? Nice power power jam kill.
Yeah.
For them, they were able to just hang her up enough to get Mia out of the box.
Yep. Contain the stop the bleeding at 4 points. And Buenos Diaz able to notch one more point on the second pass. And so 70-49 is your score. I see the official review. Hand signal being called for? Maybe
it
not.
Says official. Okay, there we go. Rainy City.
Kind of came out there looking like the.
it's yeah, it's a
whatever
triangle.
Whatever that's
maybe?
Called. Yeah, the triangle.
Okay, so I'm gonna go run some more. And
wait.
So maybe
oh, okay.
You can. Do you want to talk about things?
No.
Things and stuff?
Well, I'll talk about things
You're
and stuff.
You're a professional. You can do this.
Yes, I can definitely kill
I'm
some time
I'm running
here.
Up and downstairs. You can talk. Okay.
It's a deal.
Okay.
Let's do this. All right. Well, as I mentioned, we do have two more high-quality games coming up here to wrap things up at ECDX 2019 at 6 o'clock. The Texas, number 6 Texas Roller Girls Texecutioners will be taking on number 11 Crime City Rollers All-Stars. And then we will have number 16 London Roller Girls London Brawling going up against number 21 Windy City, the Windy City Rollers All-Stars. So definitely tune in for that. And going to take a peek around here and see where Gotham is up 84-4 over Atlanta with under 10 minutes left in the first half. 84-4 confirming that score in the Gotham-Atlanta game. But that game, this game, and every other game this weekend being brought to you by the Derby Apex. All right, and we are underway here now in jam number 18. And it looks like Persephone with the star for Philadelphia. And that is Ella Diablo jamming for Rainy City. The pack tangling up just the other side of turn one. And Persephone getting recycled back behind the pivot line. Ella Diablo now doing a bit of a beasting herself to put out Persephone and taking an outside lane and able to pick up lead jammer for Rainy City. You're back.
I am back. That was a lot of running to find out they used it as a timeout.
Well, our listeners,
you know,
thank you. Yes.
I am getting my steps in. I'm getting a little workout, a little cardio. Fine.
Well, the net result of that jam, Rainy City, of course, they were able to take lead jammer and put up 3 points there before the jam was called. So a 70-52 score is what we have with under 2 minutes left here in the first half. Rainy City will send number 5, Lauren Swaffield, to the Frogmouth jam line to be opposed by number 501, Reptar, jamming for Philly.
Oh, immediate.
Yep.
Penalty for the pivot of Rainy City. That's Bonchet.
Number 88, Bonchet. Meanwhile, back in the pack, Reptar getting knocked to the inside, having to recycle now. Halfway down the line.
Penalty picked up by number 34, Jail Bars.
And Reptar now trying to find room and only one rainy blocker to beat, able to do so. Lead
yes.
Jammer, Philly Roller Derby.
So that was Menace at the front of the pack there. Oh, again. Reptar is just able to sneak through that defense of Rainy City.
Yep. And Swaffield is out of the pack now, coming back into the pack in turn one. Reptar will call a jam and prevent Swaffield from getting any points.
So the penalty box did clear out on that one. So we'll have full force teams out on the Frogmouth jammer line.
Yeah, that's a plus. So 7 points on the jam for Philly. That puts them at 77. 0 on the jam for Rainey. 52 is their total. And 18 seconds left on the game clock. But we will get one last jam start in. And that is number 7, Mia with the star for Rainy City. Corny Herman jamming for Philly Roller Derby.
Oh, nice. Big hits in there.
That was like a combo hit and spin. And awarded lead jammer, Corny Herman now back in the pack on a scoring pass.
Rolo Tomasai was just all up in the business of Philly. Trying to get that jammer through. The jammer did make it through. Unable to put any points on the board there for Rainy City. But, man, that was some good work.
That was some good work. Good work by both teams thus far in the first half. The score is Philly 80, Rainy City 52 as we go into halftime. And so a very active and dynamic contest thus far.
Yes.
Rainy City coming out early and, you know, manifesting some strength. but Philly able to keep it together and take the lead, and they have yet to look back. So.
Okay. I can't tell. It's backwards on the screen. Yes.
So, yeah. So, Philly in the lead as we go into halftime here. And, yeah, there it is. I can see 4 points on the board for Atlanta. I'm sure Gotham
that's
has
what's happening
more than
there.
That's what's happening over there.
Yes.
But, yes, thank you for tuning in, everybody. Thanks to the Derby Apex for bringing you this broadcast. Mm-hmm. ECDX 2019, day three. A little tear coming down because the tournament's almost over.
Almost. Two more games.
But give us about 9 minutes, come back, and we'll give you some more D-Day. There we are.
Hi.
Welcome back, everybody.
We moved the computer so I didn't have to lean over somewhere.
All right, so welcome back to game number 46 here on day three, ECDX 2019, brought to you by the Derby Apex, Philly Roller Derby, and WFTDA.TV. I'm still Sexy Beast.
I'm still Ruby Longstocking.
I think so.
I think, yeah.
Yeah.
That's true.
And we are bringing you a game between Philly Roller Derby Liberty Bells and the Rainy City Roller Derby All-Stars, which has been kind of fun, kind of fast.
Very fast.
Yeah.
Very fast.
And with Philly in front, 80-52. Like we mentioned, we may have mentioned before, we don't have a producer, so we don't have any kind of fancy numbers to bring you.
Don't have too many fancy numbers, but yeah. I was just looking at the penalties as we came on air. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10. So they're pretty even.
Yeah.
So the penalties for the Philly is they have 17 total. And look at that beautiful graphic on the screen. So 15 for the Rainy City. So you can see they're fairly evenly spread.
Right.
Nobody's going out there and picking up 4 or 5 penalties.
Right.
So even though we may have seen several visits to the box, no one's going crazy out there.
Yeah, and I'm looking at jammer penalties. Rainy City, Fred Finta with 2, Mia with 1, Fairy Quake with 1, and so 4 jammer penalties. That's not that bad. Persephone with 1.
Herman with 0.
Rousey with 2. So 3 for Philly. So a 4-3 split. That's not, that's not like a
it's been
anything is on fire. Or
very
anything.
Even, right?
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
Yep, totally. But Philly defensively, both teams defensively, able to keep it locked down. And Philly maybe with just a slight jammer advantage, and that explains the score differential, 80-52, as we mentioned, as we're about to get underway here in jam number one of the second half. And so a fun game and an exciting game. Both teams are undefeated on the weekend. So Rainy City 2-0, Philly 1-0. So it'll be exciting to see how this game shakes out. Philly number 9 in the WFTDA, Rainy City number 10. So again, a very close pairing between these two squads.
Right.
And that whistle starts the jam number 1 here in the second half. And we've got Corny Herman going up against Amia to get things started.
Lots of thinking there right off that whistle.
Yeah. People kind of
tiptoe back and forth here to see what happens. Kind of testing the waters.
But it's Corny Herman up front against one blocker, and that's advantage Corny Herman. And she will break through to pick up lead jammer.
Mia was coming up quickly on the outside lane. Got a little bump as she came out of the pack there, but also out of the pack on the initial.
All right, so Corny Herman able to break through and complete a 4-point pass there. Oh. It's a 4-point pass, but you only get 2 points for it, so.
Funny how that happened.
Sorry about that. So 82-52 is the score. And because Derby math is fun, that is a 30-point lead for Philly.
Mm-hmm. I think math is fun. You can disagree.
Okay.
Feel free to disagree, but I think it's fun.
Okay.
I think more people should do it just for fun. I think they should just do maths.
Easy math is fun. I don't know. I was an English major.
As
and those
was
2 years of college were the best 2 years of my life. So. Anyway, underway here in jam number 2 of the second half. Oh, and it's a power opportunity for Philly as number 81, Fairy Quake, headed to the penalty box for Rainy City. And 501 Reptar with the star for Philly on the track, the only jammer right now. And a full complement of Philly blockers will do their best to slow the pack down. And they're going to break off a couple of blockers to go up and assist. That's number 21, Tramagotchi, your captain.
But man, the Rainy City able to reform, hanging on. Oh yeah.
That was a cutting the track penalty for Reptar.
And guess what?
Yeah, it happened just as Fairy Quake exited the box.
So this will be
a full 30 seconds.
29 and almost.
29.9.
0.9, yeah, there you go. 29.9 seconds.
I think that's math. I'm pretty sure those are numbers.
They are numbers.
All right, well, the jam's still underway. Reptar is able to exit the box now, back into the pack. And for some reason, Fairy Quake also leaving the box. I guess we missed another jammer penalty because we were talking about math. But so now both jammers on the track. Everybody's on the track. And we've got 27 seconds left on the jam clock. Rainy City will send their pivot number 88.
Bonche.
To the penalty box. Oh, and also their jammer once again.
Once again. So, okay. I was just saying.
What is going on here? Both jammers went into the box.
Yeah. Well, see, we have our officials not understanding that. I imagine we're going to have official timeout here.
There's a question mark up there on the list.
81, Fairy Quake with three, a high block, a forearm, and a cut. And then 501 is Reptar's name, number,
yeah.
Right? Okay,
yeah,
so
yeah.
We have a cut track and then a question mark, so I think we're going to get some clarification here.
And I think I just saw the one of the penalty box officials signal for an official timeout.
Right. And that is, so let me tell you here who's keeping us in check here.
Okay.
So the officials are Armaker. Recordian is our head skating official. Bibbidi Bobbidi Boom, Shebra. Wife of Pathic Signals, Queen Victoria, Empower, Art to Deku, and Strong Female Character all on skates. Betty Mercury is our jam timer, who you'll see giving us the signals out there on the track. Carrie DeWay, Wills Boer, Tornado Alley, Rule Booker, yours truly, Ms. Hyde, Optimus Prime, and Jooligan.
Yeah. So they're going to get that sorted out. Jam number two, kind of a weird jam right there. It seemed like
it was
both jammers cycled to the box twice. And didn't spend any time there, so maybe perhaps a misunderstanding.
Maybe
they
misunderstanding.
Went to the box, weren't supposed to, got cleared from the box. But, yeah. Anyway, I'm sure we will get information.
Yeah, because one of the penalties has been taken off of Fairy Quake's list here.
There you go.
So that last penalty... But that doesn't mean that's settled. That just means that is what the computer says right this second.
That's right.
It does will refresh for us. But and we still have a question mark beside Reptar's penalty. So we don't know what that one is.
Yes.
And we have a question mark beside Bonche now. So you see we're getting lots of different little bits of information up here. So maybe the wrong jammer. I mean, maybe the wrong skater reported the box. They said 81, but they meant 88, right?
Like, it can happen.
So that could be.
Yep. We got the two venues, the two tracks, pretty close to each other. There's
right.
Often a little bit of whistle bleed. Sometimes they're, you know, people can mishear things.
I'm quite sure our listeners can hear some of this happening behind us.
Oh yeah,
it's thumping over there.
I wonder if they were able to hear the. The ecstasy that was exploding in the venue yesterday when Gritty came by.
Well, they had Gritty first on track two, and then they came here.
And then Gritty came over here.
So there was a lot of ecstasy.
Yeah.
So I can't imagine that they did not hear that.
People initially thought Gritty would terrify people, but it turns out Gritty just makes people happy, you know? So, anyway. We, of course, were not able to go interact with Gritty.
We were not able to interact with Gritty because we were calling a very exciting game.
We are grown-ups and we had responsibilities.
Well, I don't know about all that now. Don't get carried away.
Yeah, let's not, you know, let's not overstate it. Anyway.
So, it looks like a penalty removed from Fairy Quake and given instead to Bonche. So that is the forearm. So maybe there was just a miscommunication about who was supposed to report to the box.
Right.
So,
and I see that question mark. That was the second of two penalties for Reptar has now been changed to a X, signifying a cutting the track penalty. So.
So maybe we've gotten everything settled now. We do want to assign the correct penalties to the correct person.
Yeah, confidence in our officiating restored, I would say.
Yes.
So, but we are still in an official timeout. 3.5 minutes now on the the official timeout. Is that an OTO?
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Or an auto, if you will.
But you know, what's happening is they're dancing on the Frogmouth jammer line.
Yep.
So I'm going to tell you about Frogmouth is roller derby uniforms and practice wear. Size inclusive, gender neutral, skater made, woman owned, and derby owned. That's Frogmouth.
And Swaffield versus Rousey, and Swaffield is going to take this round out front first and lead jammer for Rainy City. Back into the pack between the lines now on a scoring pass as Rousey gets recycled to the jammer line.
So Swaffield hit or miss in terms of being able to break through the Philly defense here. We're getting to see a successful engagement with that defense, but every once in a while they'll have her number, but this time she's...
And it is going to be a power jam for Lauren Swaffield as Rousey has headed to the penalty box on a cutting the track penalty. So Rainy City defense able to draw a cut there. And Swaffield will get knocked to the outside, secure 3 points on that second pass, and call the jam, icing the Philly jammer in the box. So a 7-0 jam for Rainy City. 86-59 is our score now, 25 minutes remaining here in the game.
Rousey only in the box for a few seconds, and so this will be merely, I was going to say 25 seconds, right?
I would say 25
seconds.
25 seconds,
something like that, that they have for the power start. So that is the opportunity that they need to sort of, Rainy City needs to kind of break out there and start to put some points on the board to close that gap.
And now Mia with the star for Rainy City now navigating to the front of the pack and able to escape the clutches of the Philly defense and secure the lead jammer position.
So yeah, the defense here for Rainy City had jail bars captured, and so they were able to stretch the pack out, and a very, very nice strategy.
All right, so Rousey out of the penalty box looking to either offer or take the star through the pack, and so...
It looks like maybe a back block assessed. Back block assessed
to
Mia.
Yep.
So the lead will be lost. We'll run out the remainder of the 1 minute and 15 seconds. Manche with the face of disappointment as she hits it to the penalty box.
And so now Rousey back on the track in a on a scoring pass. Going to encounter three Rainy City blockers at the front of the engagement zone. All right, so Rousey getting recycled back to the jammer line as Bonchet exits the penalty box. And Mia, of course, having already exited the box, is now at the front of the engagement zone trying to break through and complete a scoring pass.
I want to point out there are 0 points on the board right now. That doesn't mean there isn't the pocket points or whatever.
Yeah. Points earned, but
zero to zero. Okay, wait. Okay, as soon as I said it. See, use your voice for good.
That's right, and good in this case being 4 points going up for Mia. Bonchet headed back to the penalty box.
That is five for Bonchet.
Five trips for Bonchet. And so in addition to the four-point pass for Rainy City, they will get 2 more points on a second pass. Philly able to secure 4 points of their own, so 90-65 is our score. And that is a 25-point difference between these two teams as another official timeout is called.
Everybody.
I can see Coffee, the alt ref, going in to check on the business. And speaking of business, don't forget the Derby Apex. The Derby Apex, your independent source for women's flat track derby news, rankings, and more. Visit thederbyapex.com and follow them on Twitter at the Derby Apex. And the Derby Apex and all of the Derbyverse just absolutely aflutter at the introduction of stats.wfda.com. Mm-hmm. As we go into tournament season here, they will be your primary source of information, facts, and data, and definitely the announcer's best friend.
Yes. Yeah. I love this thing. Speaking of the postseason, so this was introduced here, and I think, you know, to give people an opportunity to take a look at it and maybe make any tweaks that they need to, but postseason play is coming up beginning August 9th through 11th. That's the WFTDA Continental Cup North America West in Orem, Utah. We have August 23rd through the 25th. That's WFTDA Continental Cups North America East, and that's in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. And September 6th through the 8th, International WFTDA Playoffs in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. The 13th through the 15th, also of September, the playoffs in Seattle, Washington, International Playoffs in Seattle, Washington. October 5th and 6th, WFTDA Continental Cup Europe, and that's in Helsinki, Finland. And finally, November 15th through the 17th, the championships game in Montreal, Quebec, Canada.
Julie Bonbon.
Love it.
Yes. Yes, another fantastic postseason schedule put together by the WFTDA. And we've got the Philly coach trying to institute some hype here. All right, so
and it works a bit.
It worked a little bit. I can hear people responding.
Yes.
And so that they're responding because we're into now our second minute and change of the official timeout.
So it's Fairy Quake and Herman are standing out there on the Frogmouth Jammer line with hands on hips, staring down the walls there.
Yeah, they're not sad. They're not upset. They're just disappointed.
They're just there, just staring down.
All right. Well, here's a shout out to the officials for, you know, making the announcers try to come up with stuff to say. But don't worry, that's why we're here.
Yes.
And so we'll be happy to talk about Frogmouth, your sponsor for the ECDX 2019 Jammerline, all three tracks, Frogmouth, roller derby uniforms, and practice wear. Size inclusive, gender neutral, skater made, woman owned, and derby owned.
And just want to say again, beautiful jerseys.
Yes.
Frogmouth makes beautiful jerseys. But a shout out to all the sans serif fonts. Sans serif. Keep those on the numbers. Sans serifs.
And as we go into now our third minute of this official timeout, I will remind everybody of the remaining two contests scheduled here for ECDX 2019. Number 6, Texas versus number 11, Crime City. And number 16, London versus number 21, Windy City.
So again, my recommendation, have two screens, or your screen and screen, if you're watching that, if your technology does that sort of thing. Have two screens. We do have two feeds going at each time, this time and the next time.
And I am able to go to the stats.wfta.com and see where London, they lost to Philly. That was yesterday. But they also lost to Texas. But they beat Santa Cruz on Friday.
Yeah.
So 1-2 on the weekend, and they will be looking to even up that number against Windy City. All right. Well, it appears that the official timeout, which has just crossed the 4-minute mark, is ready
Come
to an end.
Yeah.
You could have played a Queen song during this official timeout, and it would have been cool.
And Betty Mercury getting ready to start us off here as we head into jam number 5 of the second half.
And we've
got, my goodness.
Yeah.
Another move like that.
Sort of a standing matrix, but very it quick is going to be assessed a penalty
nice.
For that.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
I thought it was very nice.
They're calling it a forearm.
Ah.
Yeah. And so that is a power opportunity for Corny Herman, who will take full advantage and escape the front of the engagement zone to pick up lead jammer position for Philly.
Monche now exiting the penalty box again with 5 penalties. Not terrible, but just needs to calm it down a little.
All right, so the pack setting up in turn 3 now as Fairy Quake exits the penalty box.
I gotta give props to Rainy City there, hanging on to Herman and not allowing the runaway there on the power jam.
Yeah, so Kearney Herman will get knocked to the outside of turn four and will choose that opportunity to call the jam, having completed a four-point pass. So Philly now at 94, Rainy City to 65. And that was jam number five here in the second half. We will soon get underway with about 20 minutes left in the game. Jam number six. And Rainy City will send Lauren Swaffield to the jammer line. And it'll be Reptar for Philly on that Frogmouth start line.
So did get some information about that official timeout and what it was about. They were officials were discussing whether to upgrade the back box to egregious and for expulsions. And after some discussion, decided not to. Maybe it wasn't egregious, still back block, but they decided not to upgrade those. And so we have everybody still here.
Good. I'm glad that only took 4 minutes. Meanwhile, back on the track, Lauren Swaffield has earned lead jammer for Rainey, and we'll be back into the pack here in a second on a scoring pass. Reptar having exited the pack and completed her initial pass. Oh, and Swaffield forced to call the jam.
So Menace picks up a cut track there, and we'll head to the box for Rainy City. So that'll be one, two, two.
Oh, goody. Another official timeout. Actually, this is an official review.
This is official review.
Yeah, those are okay.
There were two penalties there assessed on Menace. And now we're going to get an official review. And so now we have someone, the amazing Gretchen Little, is filling in on the producer role. And so I do not have to run back and forth and leave you.
Yes. Thank you. Gretchen is selfless.
She More is important, I don't have to run up and downstairs.
Yes. Yes.
To get the
I would not be able to do that if you held a gun to my head. So. Anyway, so just a quick update on our two remaining games. As we mentioned, number 16, London, 1-2 on the weekend, going up against number 21, Windy City. And thanks to the beautiful magic of stats.wfda.com, I see where Windy City is 3-0 on the weekend.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
And knowing that they, other than Philly Roller Derby, Windy City has the longest or the most expansive record at ECDX in its X number of year history. They were 8-8 coming into the weekend. And so now with those three wins, they are 11-8 at ECDX all time. And yeah, so that'll be exciting. Don't miss that. London versus Windy City. And 16 versus 21. So that's relatively close. And they should be pretty well paired during that game as we go get close to the second minute of this official review. And thankfully, Gretchen is down there and are going to retrieve that information for us.
Yeah, so we're having a little conversation there between our alt ref and all of our announcing crew. Believe me, it does take quite a few folks to get the announcing thing to run smoothly.
That is correct.
Running being the operative word.
It's a bit like an ant farm. Yeah.
Running has been a lot of things that we've done this weekend, but
I can take a quick turnaround and view the score from track number two, where Gotham Roller Derby All-Stars facing off against Atlanta.
Right.
And 147-18 is currently your score in that game, with 25 minutes and change left in that game. And so Gretchen has come back with some information about the official review, and we'll get that here in a second. Coach is returning to the bench. And officials taking their places as we get ready to start jam number seven. What do we got?
So Philly was looking for a cut track before the call off there and didn't receive it.
Ah, okay.
Did not receive it.
No call stands.
No call stands.
Yeah.
So that blinking light will ultimately go away.
Yes. The little blinky dot. All right, and we are underway now in jam number seven, and it is Mia going up against Persephone. And Mia able to take a nice spin on the inside line and come out lead jammer for Rainy City.
Mia's been very effective out there. They have held her up a couple of times, but she's been able to get out.
All right, so Mia back in the pack now on a scoring pass, trying to navigate around turn two. Mia's going to go up against number 85. That's Teflon Donna for Philly Roller Derby.
Oh, Persephone.
Oh, great.
Sneaking through there.
Yep, great defense by Philly, able to hold up Mia long enough for Persephone to squeak through.
Mia still working, but getting hung up there. That's number 45, Built to Spill, hanging up Mia. I didn't use my announcer curse for good. I said that Mia usually can handle the defense, and not this time.
No, and as a matter of fact, it's a 2-1 ratio in favor of Philly on that jam, 8-4. And
so I'm going to say she normally does not handle them at all. And they really have her number.
They must.
And she can't ever get through the pack. There we go.
There we go.
So I'll use my announcer voice for good.
That's it. So a 102-71 score with Philly in front. Under 19 minutes left here in the game. And Rainy City will send Fairyquake to the Frogmouth Jammer line. And Fairyquake will get through first and earn lead jammer status for Rainy City. Back in the pack now on a scoring pass. Buenos Diaz trying to navigate past the Rainy blockers at the very front of the engagement zone. Is that a clean move? And it is.
It was that was an incredible balance there for her. Just on one foot primarily.
And so a two-point, hard-earned two-point pass there for Rainy City. That puts them at 73 now to 102 still for Philly. So I'm sensing a pattern here for Philly versus Rainy City. Philly able to flex multi-pass jams. Mm-hmm. And Rainy City really only able to lock down, 4 points or less in the times where they have been lead. Here we go again into jam number 9, Corny Herman and Lauren Swatfield with the stars for their respective teams.
That's Lily Gaskell with a pivot stripe for Rainy City. We've said that name quite a few times already in this game. Almost out. Bell, so that was, and Frankenstein that went out of bounds, battling up against Swatfield. Swatfield not designated lead, however. Just in the nick of time, Philly picks up that lead and calls it off, but no points awarded, so just in the nick of time.
Yeah, Corny Herman able to get lead and call the jam and prevent any Rainy City scoring from happening. So,
a split second later, and they would have lost points on that one, but managed to keep it.
Yeah, great defense there by Anne Frankenstein, able to chase the windy jammer down and put her out. All right, here we go, jam number 10, second half. And we've got Fred Finta and Reptar. Reptar at the front. Three Rainy City defenders to beat, and able to do so. Lead jammer Philly.
Yes. That was a big sweep there by Rascal. Didn't quite land it. And so when you don't land the big sweeping hits, you do open up a space for that opposing jammer. Sometimes you got to go for it, though. But when you miss, risk big, you miss big.
That's right. You miss 100% of the blocks you don't take.
That is correct.
Yeah.
Who said that?
Somebody famous.
Somebody famous.
All right. Well, here
we
go.
You know what somebody else famous said?
What's that?
Bonchet.
Bonchet. Where is Bonchet? Bonchet. All right. So it is Fairyquake and not Bonchet with the star for Rainy City. And Buenos Diaz jamming for Philly.
Just a lot of lockdown happening at the pack. We haven't moved but about a couple inches from the Frogmouth Jammer line.
Yeah. Great combo between Built to Spill and Teflon Donna.
Gosh.
Just absolutely bookending Fairyquake there. Oh, Fairyquake going to find room on the inside?
Wow.
In fact, she will. And that was exciting. A quick move and taking lead jammer position.
There's the lockdown from again.
Fairyquake going up on one skate on the outside and able to do a quick spin and complete a scoring pass. first points in a couple jams for Rainy City.
Yeah.
And we've had a star pass now for Philly.
It started out with, back block assist.
All right, so with a minute and a few seconds left on the jam clock, I hope Rainy City will know that they can run it long now.
Yeah.
Two scoring passes complete. That's going to be the first multi-pass jam for Rainy City.
Two penalties that look like assessed to that jammer, built a spill. I'll keep an eye on this penalty tracker here. Yeah. So the insubordination either for not leaving the tracker, maybe hitting the penalty box too hard.
All right, so very quick check on the bench and being given direction to call the jam, having been knocked out of bounds, but able to complete three scoring passes for a total of 12 points. And so that puts them under 20 points behind Philly. 104-86 is your score. 14 minutes remaining. Rainy City with opportunities here. If they can capitalize on them, they can find themselves getting back into this game.
Yeah, and interesting here, Built to Spill is the one with the jammer star sitting for the second penalty in the penalty box. So this will be a power start for Rainy City. And Built to Spill is not one of the regular jammers in rotation. And so, interesting opportunity here for Rainy City.
Yeah. Mia is definitely one of the regular jammers for Rainy City.
Absolutely.
And she is now lead jammer. As the pack moves gradually down the far straightaway, Mia's going to try to navigate through that cloud of defenders at the front.
Everybody out of bounds.
Wow. And a penalty assessed to the Philly Roller Derby pivot now.
It's number 21. So, they put in Tramagotchi. That's the team captain with a pivot stripe for Philly.
All right, and Built to Spill back in the pack now as Mia comes around on her second scoring pass and able to complete that very deftly, moving to the outside lane. And Built to Spill has completed her initial pass. So
see what Mia does with this control of the track.
Oh, nice.
Oh.
Now, Mia is lead and can call this jam, but it looks like Rainy opting to run it a little bit here.
Yeah, you see the motion from the bench. Keep it going because maybe Built to Spill is not, again, on that regular jammer rotation. Maybe they're hoping that the defense can hang on to her.
37 seconds left on the jam
clock. It looks like Philly's doing a good job of hanging on to Mia as well. Philly just sitting there on the jammer.
Yep.
Rainy City having a bridge. So now everybody rushes back. Nice.
So Built to Spill able to put up 4 points. And let's see if any more points will get awarded to Mia on the jam as the jam comes to an end. 12 points on the jam for Rainy City. So a 108-98. Score, under 12 minutes remaining in a 10-point differential. That is totally manageable.
It is totally manageable.
Oh, and
that's your favorite kind of math.
Right? Even more points will go up now as Rainy City will exceed the 100-point mark, 108-101.
101.
So the only thing better than being 10 points behind is only being seven points behind.
Yeah. That's right.
And a timeout for Rainy City. An interesting strategy to use. Oh, no, it's a timeout for Philly.
Yeah. So
we are dependent on the technology that we have here.
Well, Betty Mercury was like, it is over there.
Yeah.
And so, got you.
I was going to say, it didn't seem to make sense that Rainy would take a timeout right then.
Right.
You know, and they would just as soon get their jammer back on the track and start the next jam. But Philly there willing to pause for the cause as they find themselves only 7 points ahead now.
So it looks like Philly's coach out in the infield taking a few moments with the officials, and so maybe that has something to do with that timeout. So that rolling whistle indicates that the timeout has completed, and if we need to take more time, we'll need to be on an official timeout.
All right, we've gone from a team timeout to an official timeout. And I see an official walking over to the scorer's table, or the penalty bench, actually.
So we do have some officials conferring in the infield there, just making sure. I'm wondering if,
an update from track two. Gotham Girls Roller Derby All-Stars up 193-22 over Atlanta.
So I think I've heard a rolling whistle now, and Betty Mercury is preparing to give us the 5 seconds. Or did give us the 5 seconds. There are a lot of voices in this venue.
And the net result is that we are underway here in jam number 13 of the second half. It is Corny Herman versus Lauren Swaffield. Corny is already at the front of the engagement zone and able to break loose of the remaining Rainy City blocker and secure that lead jammer position.
So that was Faye Roberts that was at the front of the pack. Now this is interesting. This is Lily Gaskell wearing the star here for Rainy City. Has played out there as a defender, but we've said her name many times.
Yep.
Really hanging onto the jammer, locking down that defense, but didn't get to show us too much of her jammer skills on that one. But
Lily Gaskell, obviously, with great value as a pivot, but certainly adept as a jammer. And it would be interesting to see her in a scenario where she gets to run a full two-minute jam as a jammer. That would be pretty.
I mean, because one of the pivot's jobs is to take that star and be the jammer, right? So those skills are important, too. Little bump out there for Mia. Mia is just not going to do it. Philly coming back, trying to trap the jammer. Mia's trying to now race in so she can get in before they get all the way back around the track. And now it's a foot race.
Oh.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow. So Mia going full speed into number 34 jail bars for Philly there, but able to recover.
Now, Reptar is lead jammer. Okay, interesting little thing there. Reptar was declared lead jammer, and a back block will be assessed to Mia.
So Philly going to take advantage here. Four points on the board already, 116-101, your in-jam score update. And with Mia in the penalty box,
oh my.
Reptar is free to score with impunity.
And does.
The second of two scoring passes already complete.
We've already seen Reptar put up a lot of points for Philly. Rascal getting held up there by Philly, trying to hang on to a defender. So Rascal's going to try to get a hip in there. Doesn't quite land it, but it's enough to get out from behind the Philly wall.
Mia out of the box now, back into the pack.
Get a little help from my friend's shirt, and that is a good one.
All right, so a no pass, no penalty, and an initial pass complete for Mia.
So Rainy City, Reptar was coming through and making it through that defense, but at that point, Rainy City was able to lock down, and everybody released from the penalty box, which probably had a lot to do with it. But so we have two players sitting on five penalties, one each team, number 34 for Philly. And that's jail bars.
Yep.
And number 88, Blanchet.
Blanchet, the pivot extraordinaire for the Rainy City All-Stars.
Rainy City.
And speaking of Rainy City, they have called a timeout here with 9 minutes remaining. 123-101 is your score. So that differential expanded slightly by Philly with an 11-0 jam there in jam 14.
Something that run back, the bump out of the jammer for Rainy City, and Reptar bumping out Mia and running back.
Yeah.
Didn't work out quite like she had hoped, I think, but worked out, right?
Yeah.
Like, was able to sort of lock the jammer down for a little bit.
Yep.
And allow her to make at least two scoring passes.
It worked a treat ultimately.
Mm-hmm.
But now it's an opportunity for our officials to get together and talk to each other again.
Yes.
Whatever it is they haven't figured out, they are going to take the time to do that.
Get lots of cheers in the house. Again, Rainy City's first time in Pennsylvania. That's fun.
Yeah.
The weather has been outstanding for them. I'm certainly happy they have been here.
Yeah, and they obviously got here in time not to have their travel impacted by the by the garbage weather that preceded ECDX.
Yes.
And was the result of which was that a number of teams had games rescheduled on the first day of the tournament.
Yeah.
as travel was interrupted from elsewhere in the U.S., specifically California, Santa Cruz.
Yeah.
Not able to get here Thursday. Had to fly on Friday. Weren't able to start their games until Saturday. And then I know some skaters from Detroit wound up having their flights canceled or delayed. And
it's been the weather. You can't predict the weather, right? But yeah, once everybody got here,
yeah,
the weather was great.
Yeah, exactly.
They've
exactly.
had the DJ out by the pool.
Yeah,
everybody's
yeah.
Hanging out. And
Saturday and Sunday, very nice, very sunny.
So,
all right. Well, as we go into the 2 minute and 20 seconds of the official timeout, obviously our officials need a little bit more time to figure things out. They've been out there the whole game. And
yeah,
yet,
they look very intent.
Yeah, they're focused.
You know, they're very really discussing something out there. They're all leaned forward into their little huddle. And of course, as an official, you want your games to be as correct as humanly possible. As they
yes.
record this on something like stats.wftda.com, right?
Well, I'm glad to see that they have it figured out now, and everybody will return to their positions so that the point of the contest, the game, can resume. And shout out to the London Roller Girls, who have instituted a dance party down here on track 3 in preparation for their game.
Yeah, it's a good way to keep warm, you know, keep your muscles warm while you're getting ready for your game.
All right, well, we are underway now here finally in jam number 15. And Corny Herman once again able to explode through the pack and grab that lead jammer position.
Yeah. Oh. And the pivot for Rainy City picking up that penalty.
That's Lily Gaskell, yeah. And we have had a star pass now for Rainy. Did we get a star pass? No. Star stash, maybe? No. Star still on the helmet. Out of play, I see. Out of play was the penalty call. Thank you, Gretchen. I confused your out of play hand signal with the star pass hand
yes.
signal. Yeah. All right, well, Corny Herman wasn't confused, and she was
not
able to complete two scoring passes.
Corny Herman has not been confused.
Nope.
This and whole game.
So able to stretch that point differential to 30 points now, 131 to 101 in favor of Philly. 8 minutes left on the game clock here in the game. And this jam, we'll see number 5, Lauren Swaffield, going up against number 501, Reptar. And Reptar finding plenty
nice.
Of room on the inside there somehow.
So, Rainy City down two blockers. Really big track advantage to Philly.
Oh, yeah. Lily Gaskell not messing around.
It's
a nice block
you.
There. On 416, Crankdat getting knocked to the inside, but able to recover. And so Reptar lead jammer now. One scoring pass complete.
Oh, my goodness. Big pile up there on turn 2. Everybody up and engaging.
Wow. That is a showdown between number 99, Russian Bayou, and Lauren Swaffield. And Russian Bayou wins.
Swaffield not able to quite keep that balance.
Oh, we have a ref takedown on the inside. Refs taking each other down. I hope that doesn't mean we'll have another 3 minute official timeout.
So look at this.
Yeah.
This is a star pass. Now we get to see our
Lily Gaskell jamming. Yeah.
Lily Gaskell doing some work there. I always wonder when blockers take the star clearly great defender out there.
Yeah.
But picks up a high block.
Ugh.
So, and a very tall human she is.
And that is going to be a fifth trip for Lily Gaskell. So, I was going to send a shout out to number 6955 Menace for Rainy City. Able to drop a great block there. Oh, what a great note there. Russian Bayou turns out started with Harrisburg. Is that HARD?
Uh-huh.
Harrisburg Area Roller Derby. And then also has skated with Dutchland. So, a Pennsylvania pedigree for Russian Bayou.
12 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's it. That is a derby career.
It is.
All right, 151 to 104 is our score with Philly in the lead. And we will get to see a full jam of Lily Gaskell because she will start in the penalty box.
She will start in the penalty box, that's right. Now, I just want to point out that there are two Philly players now with five, and that's Kamaguchi and Joe Bars, which we had the five before. But
it is Persephone jamming for Philly with the star and also with lead jammer now into the pack on a scoring pass.
Nice job there. Philly doing a great job of opening up holes, but Rainy City able to fill them really quickly. And now we have Lily Gaskell out of the penalty box, trying to get through that Philly defense now. Persephone out of the pack on the scoring pass, and Lily Gaskell also through, manages to stay in bounds on that pass and has completed the initial.
And the London Roller Girls now dancing on camera off the track.
Oh, look at that.
Yes. What many Rainy City fans wanted to see, Lily Gaskell jamming and putting up points.
Now built to spill off Philly also with five. So that's three players with five penalties on Philly.
Wow. Well, with 4 minutes and 15 seconds left on the game clock, we'll see if that becomes a factor. Yeah, built to spill, Jail Bars, and Tramagotchi each with five. So obviously like, they've been elemental in the defense of this game. Oh, goody, goody, a timeout.
Yeah, timeout.
Oh, it's a Rainy City timeout. Thank goodness.
It's an actual team timeout.
Yeah.
They needed a few moments to talk before.
So then this is their last timeout. They do still have their official review. So they do have one more stoppage if they need it. Philly with two timeouts, and they have exhausted their official review. So 4:15 left on the game clock, 157 to 108 our score. And don't forget, coming up on this track after this game, it's going to be London going up against Windy City. And they're on track number two, last game of the day on track two. That's Texas versus Crime City. Let me just click on stats.wfda.com under the Texas.
While you're doing that, let me tell everybody, let me give one more shout out to the Derby Apex for bringing you this broadcast all week long at ECDX 2019. Your independent source for women's flat track derby news, rankings, and more. Visit TheDerbyApex.com and follow them on Twitter at TheDerbyApex.
All right, and what a coincidence. Texas earning 224 points in each of their two games, beating Atlanta and London. And so they will go
maybe
up against the...
Maybe they're going to try to do three for...
Well, let's see if it can happen.
224.
Let me just get my bookie on the phone. And all right, so now Philly is going
to
take a timeout.
A timeout for Philly. Wow, okay. You know, when they're playing, it's a pretty fast game,
it
right?
Is.
Like,
it's a fun
it's
game.
It's a very fun game to watch. But we've had several...
Stoppages
that didn't have to do with... timeouts.
With the game.
And they just like being on TV, maybe. I mean, you know.
Sure.
They don't get paid for being here, so let them be on TV.
Let them be on TV.
That's cool, man. So let me give a shout out to our other sponsor, which we've mentioned before, but want to call them out again. Frogmouth, sponsor of the Jammer Line, is roller derby uniforms and practice wear. Size inclusive, gender neutral, skater made, woman owned, and derby owned. That's Frogmouth.
And everyone, don't forget, you're watching Philly number 9 and Rainy number 10. So those two teams will definitely be involved in the WFTDA postseason. And you can get your tickets for the 2019 International WFTDA Playoffs and Championships. They are on sale now with discount codes available. Get your tickets and codes today at WFTDA.com/tickets.
And get them in the next day or two. Because they are seriously selling out very quickly.
Yep. All right, here we go. Underway in jam number 18. Four minutes left in the game.
Nice bump out there on Mia. But Mia's able to quickly come back. It's Courtney Herman at the front of the pack. No, there is no really front of the pack anymore. It's just collapsed on one another.
It's like a worm. Which end is the front?
It is just Oh, big hit there by Lily Gaskill, and I think there is going to be a cut track. She's able to draw that cut track.
Nice.
On Herman.
So Courtney Herman into the penalty box now, and Mia getting recycled back to the pivot line.
So Mia's got 30 seconds here, a few less than 30 seconds, to try to do something for Rainy City. Everybody collapsing, and finally just push her out. We're just going to give you a little assist.
All right, so pack advantage at least for the moment for Rainy City, and that is going to allow Mia to get through on a second scoring pass. So a total of 8 points on the jam for Rainy as Courtney Herman returns to gameplay.
Oh,
and just edges right there on the inside corner,
yeah,
and able to get through and complete her initial pass, no problem.
So the bench telling Mia, yeah, to call it, which she does.
Yep. Yeah, no longer the time necessarily to run it, but
right,
instead to prevent Philly scoring as possible. So 11 points on the jam. That's one of very few multi-pass jams,
yeah,
for Rainy City in the second half. 119 is their score, 157 for Philly, as we are about 2.5 minutes left in the game.
So we've had both of these jammers on the jammer line before. That is Fairy Quake taking on Reptar. And Fairy Quake making the move to the outside lane is able to get out of the pack. Reptar getting caught up now in a mass of bodies, and big hit there.
Who is that? Number 66, Little Loca. Nice
very
move.
Very nice, yeah, yeah. Just a very solid hit. Oh,
and another one. The double Loca has got number 81, Fairy Quake, kind of stuck at the back of the pack now.
Yep.
Reptar is out of the pack. Initial pass complete.
And Fairy Quake taking a look at the bench and does call it off wisely.
I don't think Randy was. Oh, look at that. They were able to get 2 points. So 36 points separating these two teams now with a minute and a half left. 157 to 121. Philly in the lead.
I mean, I guess if you can't make this multi-pass, you got to keep Philly from scoring if you're Rainy City, right?
That's right. Absolutely.
So even if you didn't get the full four on that one, call it before Philly can get in there. Wow. We've got lots of cheering happening here, lots of fans.
Yeah.
In the building. We do have a full... maybe you can see on your camera on occasion, it looks like the bleachers are completely empty, but that's because everyone's sitting inside.
Everybody's trackside.
Everybody's in the track. I mean, yeah, who wants to be outside when you can be inside?
All right, well, Mia with the star once again for Rainy City, and she is lead jammer 3 in a row for Rainy now. And
Persephone
is jamming for Philly.
And I think Persephone might have snuck in a few points there.
Wow. Indeed.
So
2-2 jam, yeah. So. Everything even on that jam for both teams. 159 to 123 is our score. 30 seconds left on the game clock. And it looks like Rainy City will take a timeout.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's an official review after
timeout. Official
review.
Rainy City will take
the
official review, sure.
Okay.
I would wager they're going to take that as a timeout.
So we don't have to run anywhere, downstairs.
Not to
we
do anything.
We can just hang out.
Yeah, just breathe.
It's been... I do like the bird's eye view of the track. It's very nice, but it does present its own challenges, its own speed bumps, you know.
Yeah.
Getting information up and also seeing through the netting. And.
Well, that makes it a true bird's eye view because you kind of have to turn your head to the side to sort of see what
see
what is happening
thing
in front of you. Yeah. We were talking about tickets and the WFTDA postseason. The pack is here. Get a 4-pack of 3-day tickets to either of the playoffs. That is Winston-Salem or Seattle, for only $175. That is a deal. That's $175 American. That's $85 off the regular price. Get your tickets now to the best events in roller derby at wftda.com/tickets.
Slash tickets. Don't forget
and,
the slash.
Yeah, and don't forget the slash because the slash is already there. They have slashed the price by $85 for the Pack Is Here promotion. So. You and three of your friends can enjoy.
Get your tickets quickly and also get them as cheaply as possible.
All right, so the London Roller Girls are, in fact, cheering on Rainy City.
Of
and
course.
That is some some country ship there, the wonderful teams from the UK.
Yes.
Supporting each other.
Very quick wearing the star for Rainy City. And a penalty will be assessed to Menace. So, oh, I'm sorry. I thought Menace had already had five. No, Menace does not have five now. Menace.
All right. Well, Philly was able to get lead jammer and then call the jam as the game clock expired. So,
down, yeah.
Unofficially, 159 to 123 is the score.
Really good showing by both teams. I mean,
absolutely. Absolutely. So Rainy City will go 2-1 on the weekend, and Philly will go 2-0. And so good job for the Philly Roller Derby Liberty Bells going 2-0 on the ECDX 2019.
It's not totally surprising that you see the number 9 and number 10 ranked teams come out so closely like this, but just really...
Don't mind me while I look up my notes. I thought I had some good Philly information
there.
We have
some notes. It's good.
My notes couldn't be anywhere near as good as stats.wfda.com, so be sure and check them out for all of the info. I was trying to bring you the all-time ECDX numbers. Whoa, look at us.
The last day of a tournament.
Yeah, day three. It's always so the best day. But, so a great game, a wonderful contest. 159 to 123 your score with Philly taking the game against Rainy City. And, so a fun game. Thank you so much for joining us here.
Thanks for being here. Hope you stay tuned for the next game or games.
We got two more games left. Mm-hmm. We got whatever's going on behind us on track two between Gotham and Atlanta. And then we've got London and Windy City coming up here on track three. Mm-hmm. And Texas and Crime City on track two, and then we're going to go home.
Yeah, and thanks to Gretchen for stepping in and being our producer, because I was having trouble doing both jobs.
And thank you for watching here at the 2019 ECDX, brought to you by the Derby Apex and Philly Roller Derby and WFTD.TV. Stay tuned, still some Derby left.